Hey guys, Sneaky Snake here, Brothers in Arms, World of Warships, and today's video I have a solid teamwork replay for you. I'm playing with my buddy Puddin. He's in his tier 9 German battleship, the Friedrich der Große. I'm playing in my tier 9 Japanese destroyer, the Yagumo, and we're playing some domination here on the map Warrior's Path. So the reason why I wanted to show you guys this replay, well, I got it to hand it to myself and Puddin. We played a fantastic game here. I screened over here at Objective Alpha here at the beginning, and then we made a gigantic push into Bravo, heavily outnumbered, and, well, I'm not going to say we came out on top, but I'm not going to say we got our butts kicked. I guess you'll have to watch and find out, right? So, Puddin and I, out of the three of us, Spider, him, and myself, me and Puddin probably have the best synergy with each other. It doesn't really matter what kind of ships that we play, but it seems like our best combination comes when I'm in my destroyers and Puddin is in his battleships. I'm sure a lot of you are aware here on the channel that Puddin loves to show battleship replays, and he is certainly going to have another solid game in his Friedrich. But something that I don't usually post too often are destroyer videos. I did have a Yagumo replay about a week ago. You can check that video out in the description below, and it'll appear on your screen now. But I just love cruisers a lot more, and I love playing battleships even a lot more. I'm very good in destroyers, but there's just something about playing in cruisers and battleships where I feel like I can influence the game more, even if I do play destroyers rather well. And the Yagumo certainly here in World of Warships, it's, you know, got released a couple of weeks ago when the Japanese destroyers split. This thing is really, really nice. You get the same benefits of a Kagero with better performing guns and better AA and more hit points. You see where I'm getting with this? It's pretty nice. And to be honest with you, it's something that I think is a bit overpowered, but I hope Wargaming doesn't touch it, to be honest with you, because I enjoy this ship a lot. So here at the beginning of the game, like I said, Puddin and I are heading over here to Alpha, and I told him that I'm going to screen, so you're going to see the first bit of this video from my perspective. So as I'm moving over here, we can see an enemy Benson, there's an Otago, there's an enemy Yagumo as well. And unfortunately, our friendly gearing that is out there, Spike 7, is just taking a hammering and a beating. Even if you're in an American destroyer like so, if you go up against two destroyers in a 2v1 fight, it makes it very difficult. And when you add in a cruiser that's also shooting, you can see that he's already taken quite a few hits. So as I come around the island and do get detected, I decide to launch my torpedoes. Now, unfortunately for me, that's a bad play because those torpedoes are going to be immediately spotted by that spotting aircraft that was flying around, probably the Otago in Alpha. So those torpedoes are going to be on his screen the entire time. So we'll have to see if he does anything about that. As I swing back around, got a couple battleships and a cruiser behind me in support. Enemy torpedoes are coming in, probably from the Otago, maybe from the Yagumo as well. I do get detected and my torpedoes do appear, and it looks like I am going to register a hit on the Otago, so I gotta hand it to him. I'm not sure why he didn't get out of the way. Okay. All right. Devastating strike. That was totally unexpected. Those torpedoes were spotted the entire time, and he still ran into them. Hey, I don't know. Some people just don't pay attention. So, with that threat neutralized, that big threat that is neutralized, that tier 8 premium Japanese heavy cruiser, I decided to swing back around. Now, Puddin at this time told me that he got his hydroacoustic up, and as you can see, he is spotting all of the torpedoes that are coming out of the smoke, and probably from where the Otago, one of them does manage to hit the Yamato, and yes, there's even more torpedoes. So Puddin asked me, hey man, I need you to get back in front of me and continue to screen for ships. So, obviously, I'm going to go back and play that role very well. We do have the Cyclone coming in 315 until it does. So we'll see how it goes. Currently, there's enemy ships moving in towards Objective Charlie, and we do have some friendly forces at Bravo, but there also are a couple of enemy ships at Bravo as well. So at the moment, the enemy team has Objective Alpha, but we are slowly getting ready to cap this. And other than that, they do have a slight 5-point lead at the moment. We've lost two, they've lost two. So as I continue around, I'm up to 34,000 points of damage. One ship sunk off that devastating strike. The Kutuzov does get spotted. So instead of shooting at him, I kind of get... I'm not sure what I want to do, and then he gets deleted by our friendly Yamato. All right. Torpedoes coming in off my port side, probably from the Yagumo that's over there. And as I move on Objective Alpha, I see that there's shots coming in from that smoke screen. And as we all know in World of Warships, whenever a smoke screen is angry, it fires those shells at you and launches torpedoes. So we got to deal with it. Launch a full spread of torpedoes into the smoke, and then I tell Puddin I'm going to go forward and try and spot this guy. Somebody else does, though, the gearing player over there. So now I'm going to get my rate of fire going on the Benson here, that enemy tier 8 American destroyer. And you can see here, 5-second reload is such a buff from about the 6.8, 6.9 that you had on the Kagero, and the damage just adds up here. You can see almost 1,600 points of damage on that last salvo. Get yet another one. All six shells hit for 2,200 damage. Continue to pepper him. This Benson is not going to be able to get out of the way. 2,900. You can see the Japanese high explosive damage coming in handy right there. Yet another salvo falls in. 1,400 damage. Yet another fire, and it looks like the killing salvo is on the way. There we go. Kill number two for me. 46,000 points of damage, and now we're able to capture objective Bravo. We got 27 seconds left till we cap it, and at this point, Pwin tells me, hey man, I need you to go after that Yaguma that's over there. Well, no problem. I am at the whimsy of your commands. Continuing to make my way over there, and since we do have the Cyclone coming in, however, we do need to take out this Yaguma, because nothing is worse in any game mode, Standard or Domination, when a Cyclone hits, than having a low-health destroyer that has very good concealment range, i.e. Japanese destroyers roaming around, being able to launch torpedoes, because the concealment range is 8 kilometers whenever the storm hits. However, Japanese destroyers will always have enough of a detectability range to be able to get out of dodge when they get within 8 kilometers of a ship, so you're not able to detect them, and it's something that can be rather unfortunate. Now, at this moment, I am heading over to Puddin's point of view. I actually lagged out of the game there for a split second, and we're going to follow him for the rest of the time. It corrupted whatever was left on my replay file, so pardon me for that. However, we're going to take a look at some awesome stuff here from Puddin's point of view. So he's looking for some shots here on the Yamato, at least with his forward gun. He did have one of his turrets get knocked out. That Yamato knocked out his front turrets quite often this game. Shells are flying in at him, and he takes about 10,000 points of damage, 11,704 to be precise. So at this point, when I finally make my way back into the game, I tell Puddin I'm going to continue to go over there. He does not have his hydro up, excuse me. So I need to go over there and find this guy. He is spotted by a plane, and more shells are coming from that very angry smoke cloud over there. So I pump up to full speed on the engines, and I'm getting ready to see what I can do. That Yaguma continues to blind fire even in the smoke. Puddin has got out of the way of detection by aircraft. So now that Yaguma, if he wants to kill Puddin, he's going to have to come out of his smoke. And as Puddin starts to turn, he does get detected, but fortunately I'm out in front of him, and yeah, that Yaguma is not going to be long for his life. Puddin's looking for the shot here, gets a full broadside out. I'm starting to pepper him with my guns as well. Unfortunately, all of Puddin's shells miss. He manages to get a few target hits with his secondaries, and then I take out my third ship of the game, the enemy Yaguma. So I've screened pretty well over here at Alpha, helped kill two destroyers, and detonated the cruiser. Puddin, though, has lost quite a bit of hit points, and it doesn't appear he's going to be able to get out of the way in time from this torpedo. Hits him right on the aft end, knocks out his steering, and floods him, uses his repair. So he's at 31,000 hit points and still has a charge left coming in a minute and 11 seconds. So at this moment, he's not looking the best for hit points-wise, but these German battleships, they sure are brutes, and you can tank pretty well with them. He gets a full broadside out on the enemy Yamato that is sailing completely broadside, 12.6 kilometers away. Shots are falling in, and he does about 5,800 points of damage. So at this point, the enemy team has already taken Charlie quite some time ago, and we have a Minotaur over there. You can see 9.2 kilometers away. I have no idea what he's doing. Blindly pushing into Bravo, getting shot at by... There's a Yamato, there's an Iowa, there's a Montana over there. I'm trying to tell him, hey, dude, what are you doing? And, you know, I guess some people just don't care. Oh, well, he's going to die here really quickly. 266 to 223. We do have the lead as Puddin looks for his front guns here on this Iowa that is backing up. He gets his two forward guns shooting. See if he'd be able to get some good damage. The Minotaur is just absolutely taking a pounding right now. Puddin manages one Citadel and one Ricochet off of the Iowa for 14,000 damage, and that Minotaur is just getting eaten alive by all those ships over there. The Yaguma lands a solid hit on him, and he's going to die right about now. There he goes. The Yamato manages to kill both secondaries. So at this point, there's an enemy Iowa, there's an enemy Montana on almost full health. There was a Yaguma over there, and there's Yamato, and they're all going to be pushing into objective Bravo. So at this time, it's time to put our man pants on and see what we could do. So I tell Puddin, hey man, that Minotaur did manage to get his smoke screen down right at the last second, so I'm going to go over there and I'm going to launch some torpedoes on the right side of the island. Puddin did get his hydroacoustic up, so we have at least alleviated the destroyer problem. If he does come around the island, he will be detected by Puddin's hydro. And this is a bit of a risky play here when I do decide to launch my torpedoes into the smoke, but I do use the F3 torpedoes on the Yaguma, and it does have very fast reload, relatively speaking, compared to the other torpedoes that you can get. So as I launch my full broadside of torps into the smoke, Puddin continues to move up, and any second now he's about to detect the enemy Yaguma. 258 to 300. Puddin continues to move up. It's any second now. There it is. He gets detected. 7.8 kilometers away, the Yaguma gets spotted. Now this is the one really big thing right here. and being in a German high-tier battleship. And an American and in a Japanese, you just would not be able to do this. He lands 3,600 points of damage. My torpedoes are going right around the island, and it looks like that enemy Montana is about to take a massive hit here. I guessed correctly as he was coming around, and oh, look at those hit points just melt away. Land like 5 torpedoes, and he gets instantly killed by our friendly Iowa, so 1 battleship down. We've turned it into a 3v2. Putin's Hydro continues to mark the Shiguma up, and he's panicking. He's popping everything. He's got his smoke. He's got his speed boost. He's backing up. This guy is just absolutely screwed. Putin continues to rail him with the secondaries. He's on just 2,000 health, and I'm about ready to take kill number 2 and get it down to a 2v2. He does set a fire on the Yamato, and my next salvo comes in on the Agumo and takes care of business. So there we go. We've turned a 4v2 into a 2v2, and now Putin has the advantage against this Yamato. That Yamato, if I were him, would go for the ram because he's in a very bad situation. If he lets Putin get to his side, he's going to be able to get citadeled very easily. The Yamato's about ready to shoot his 2 forward guns, does knock out a turret, and scores another 10,000 points of damage. But right here, you're going to see the weak point of the Yamato right underneath that forward turret, 19,000 points of damage. Putin gets the citadel and gets another shell hit. He continues to set fires with the secondaries, and now he's getting ready for a drive-by with his rear turrets. The 2 forward turrets get 2 overpens. Looking, we'll see what his X turret does. 2 citadels, there we go. 2 more shots from his X or Y turret, manages 2,700 points, and that Yamato, which was at 2/3 health, is all of a sudden screwed. Putin's secondaries continue to go in. I'm getting yet another torpedo salvo out on the enemy Iowa. I get nuked by his forward turrets. The Yamato is going to continue to burn and get taken care of. 2 of my torpedoes slam home into the Iowa. Putin beaches himself. He is now side-scraping World of Tanks style at the island. We've turned a 4v2 into a 1v1, and as this Iowa comes around the corner, Putin's front guns are ready to go. He swings his turrets underneath the forward turrets of the Iowa, fires out, ba-boom! There we go. Double citadel. Iowa taken care of. Holy crap. All right. Double Confederate. Took a 4v2 and took down business. Charlie has been captured. Objective Bravo is getting captured. Putin has only 23,000 points of damage. And look at all those sinking ships. That was some epic, epic stuff. Putin up to 147,000 points of damage. 6 citadels, 2 ships killed, 160 secondary hits, 1 assisted base cap. Very solid stuff. So that teamwork right there, it was a very ballsy move to launch those torpedoes blind into the smoke. I got a little lucky and managed to hit that Montana. I was half expecting him and or the Iowa to come around the island, however, so it wasn't necessarily just a complete guess. There was a bit of intuition behind the play, but I did get rather lucky that one of those battleships at least took almost a full helping of torpedoes, and then Putin with his Hydro coming in absolutely clutch. And as Putin captures Bravo, you can just see why German BBs, I just really enjoy the fact that they have the Hydro. You start with it at the Bismarck, I believe, and you get it all the way to tier 10 with the Grosse Kurfürst. And it just changes the dynamic of engagements. No longer can those Japanese DDs just sneak up on you to the fringes of their detection range. They have to be extremely careful. And you saw right there that we were able to make them pay. So very, very solid stuff right there. And again, if that Yamato would have just turned in and rammed Putin, this game could be going a lot differently. The scores would have been 2-2 with an Iowa that still had 23,000 hit points. And our friendly Iowa over there would have been in quite the big of a problem. But nevertheless, very solid teamwork right there. And I know that was really fast-paced, and it all happened within about a minute, minute and a half, which is lightning speed for World of Warships. But at this point, Putin continues his turn. He's going to go over to sea now. The last enemy ship, it's a battleship of some sort, don't remember which one it is over there next to the mountain at Echo 8. So Putin is going to head over there and see what he can do. So, yeah, that was probably the most exciting teamwork replay that we've had on our channel, and that was just awesome. When we were playing the game, Putin and I, we were in the chat talking, obviously, and oh boy, that was some solid stuff. We were just freaking out, and then as Putin killed the Iowa, you just see him sitting there, side-scraping like a tank, and he just started laughing because it was some pretty awesome stuff. 621 to 162 the scores. The game is clearly in our hand. All we got to do is take out this last battleship, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem. Our friendly battleship on Charlie is trying to cap, and he is bow in, so he certainly is not going to be getting killed anytime soon. At least I would think so. So Putin is now swinging his turrets around, and when he goes around the island, he should have a solid attempt at snagging this final kill for him. Putin continues to go around. 654 to 162 now at this point. Putin continues. Don't know what to say. There's this very awkward silence right here after that just debauchery of excitement. 7.5 kilometers away. It's the Friedrich de Grossa on the enemy team. He's at 42,000 points of health. Excuse me. He's about half health. Putin is getting ready to go around the island and see what he can do. His friendly Iowa buddy is also off his starboard aft, and he's going to be heading around this island as well. 6.6 kilometers away, the Friedrich de Grossa is. And Putin is now ready to get his shots out. See here that even though the Friedrich de Grossa is angled in quite nicely against Putin's shells, when he shoots, he aims right at the front turrets. A few are going to hit the superstructure, and you'll see the damage that comes up. Very solid stuff. 4,000, and he knocks out a turret. So that's one thing that's really important. His secondaries are now going to town. All of a sudden, 20 secondary hits, and they're going to continue to rack up. He's now getting ready to get yet another broadside, and the Friedrich is angled even better, but once again, he's going to aim right at the superstructure. It has that gigantic block concrete pillbox of a conning tower, and you're going to see all these shells just slam right into the front of it, getting some solid penetration. There we go. 10,000. The Iowa takes care of business. What a game. What a freaking game. Taking a look now at the post-battle results. 165,000 points of damage for Putin, and the Confederate, two ships destroyed, six citadels, ends up as top on the leaderboard with me at 2,306 base XP. I ended up top at 2,633 with four ships destroyed. All of that glorious damage done. 133,000 with the secondary, or with the primary. 22,000 with the secondary. He ends up with 10,000 commander's XP. Very solid stuff. Taking a look at my post-battle results. 165,000 damage as well. 13,000 total XP with four ships destroyed and the devastating strike. Very good stuff. Almost all of it with torpedoes. 126,000 points of damage. Very solid stuff right there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this replay. Please leave a comment. Please leave a like. Maybe subscribe to the channel. And with that being said, the Sneaky Snake here for Brothers in Arms, World of Warships, signing off. Have a great day.